Never did it this way. Back in the old days, oh, we ain't a cliche. That ain't no way to treat a lady like a girl in a country song. How in the world did it go so wrong? Like our good for is looking good for you and your friends on the weekend. Nothing more. We used to give a little respect. Now we're lucky if we even get to climb up in your truck, keep our mouths shut and ride along down some old dirt road we don't even wanna be on, and be the girl in a country song.
Can you find me a heifer? Not quite. Yeah? We can get going. All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome again to Lloydminster Stockade Roundup 2020. I'm loving the compliance. Everything's beautiful. We're having a nice time. Everyone's breathing free and easy. It's perfect. All right, so here's our Speckle Park show. Class one, these are our younger yearling heifers, junior class. Just one entry, and she will be our junior champion, Speckle Park female. At this time, I'd like to mention our title sponsors, Matlock Farms, KR Livestock Supply, and Sweet Pro Feeds Canada. Sweet Pro Feeds is also doing an exhibitor draw here during the shows. Again, our major sponsors, Matlock, KR, and Sweet Pro are doing the coffee and donuts for the next few days. Mark and Jill are here from DLMS, and it's Jill's birthday. If anyone wants to send a birthday Caesar or something up here, she'd be happy to accept. This live stream of DLMS is brought to you by DLMS, Black Gold Simmental, Hagel Livestock, Turtleford Summer Cattle Show, Copeland Auctions, Alberta Ag Association, Lakeland College, City of Lloydminster, Rainy Creek Farms, Get Her Down Embroidery, and Stingray Radio. We appreciate these sponsors. We'll go through more as the day goes along. We'd also like to say that new this year, along with the Speckle Park Show, we're going to have a sale this afternoon at 5 p.m. The fellows at T-Bar C are here and have put together a great group of cattle. We're going to announce which ones are in the sale as the show goes along here today. So if you're in the Speckle Park business or want to be, you're in a great spot for that here today. So in the ring, we have Class 1 Speckle Park Show, our junior bred heifer class.
Junior bred heifer to start the show and start this division off here. I think a female that you really have to appreciate from the side, really nice down through her flank and down through her middle third, a really, really deep body kind of a female, really nice in her lines. Female that's moving all right out here today, and just a female that has cow written all over. Just a nice female to start this junior division.
Thank you, Garth. Good man. Entry 394, pardon me, is your junior champion, Speckle Park bred heifer. She is Girls Got Rhythm, 110G. Exhibited by MX Ranch, owned by Rosehill Speckle Park. All right, congratulations. We will see her later in our championship run. Our next class is Class 2. We do have one scratch, folks. Entry 101 will not be racing today. 101 is a scratch from the show in our Class 2. Our next class is our senior bred heifer class. Our top two will be our senior reserve senior champion bred heifer. At this time, I'd like to introduce again our judge for the day, Mr. Garth Rancier from Killam, Alberta, along with his wife Ange and their kids. Run Rancier Farms, Simmental breeding outfit of great stature. They've won, I believe, four pickups up in Edmonton, the only supreme champion Simmental female at Agribition, but one of the great commercial bull sales in all the land as well. So we appreciate Garth being here and sorting through cattle today. We'll see him again on Friday. And just listen to his comments, folks. This guy can find him, and he will be doing that over the next two or three days. So thank you to Garth for being here. And again, once again, we're in Class 2. Speckle Park's our senior bred heifers.
Fast.
a whale of a set of bred heifers here in this class, and I think I'm going to go ahead and use the most complete heifer in this class. I think just a massive made kind of a heifer. Heifer that you really have to appreciate when you get in behind her. She's bold, bold sprung female coming out of her rib cage and coming out of her top. A heifer that's really nice both directions out of her shoulder. Really, really upheaded and a very broody headed kind of a female. A female that really wants to flex and stretch out on the move here today. I think a female that you just have to appreciate how massive this female is. An easy winner in this class. Let's move on into these next two heifers. A pair of heifers we're splitting hairs on here today. I think a pair of heifers that are both really, really nice up through their front end, really nice coming out of their chest floor and up into their head and neck. Just a pair of heifers that have a ton of extension, very, very feminine kind of heifers, and both really, really long body kind of females. Both heifers really nice coming both directions of their shoulder as well, and both really sound. I think this heifer that I'm going to go ahead and use, I think a heifer that's just really, really nice down through her middle third here today. A heifer that when you get underneath her, you really have to appreciate the teat placement on this heifer and the amount of spacing that she has in there as well. Just two very, very complete kind of heifers to sit second and third in this class. As we move on into this heifer down at the other end of the class, I think a heifer that you really have to appreciate the length and the amount of extension that she has. An extremely long body, long spine kind of a heifer. A heifer that just gives up maybe a little bit of the softness down through her middle third of these heifers standing up above her here today in this class. Just a really, really nice set of heifers right from one end to the other in this class, though.
All right, thank you, Garth. So leading out in first place in your senior champion Speckle Park bred heifers, entry 100, KFC Girl Crest 699G from KFC Farms, Abbotsford, BC, and Didsbury, Alberta. In second place, entry 42, and she'll be reserve senior champion Speckle Park female, Outback Chromed Up 102G from Wayne Meekin at Sturgeon County, and she is in the sale. Look her up in the book. In third place, entry 22, Colgan's Gemini 02G from Colgan's Cattle Company of Saskatoon. And in fourth place, entry 41, Outback My Kind of Girl 18G, again from Wayne Meekin in Sturgeon County, and she also is in the sale. All right, so from top to bottom, entry 41 was fourth, entry 100 was first, entry 42 was second, 101 was scratched, and 22 was third. We'll see those two top heifers back in our championship run, but now we're going to move into some pairs. First of all, we've got two-year-olds, class three. Please mark in your show program lot 395. Entry 395 is not going to be with us today, so we're down to two pairs. Females born in 2018 with their calves at side.
Let it roll.
class with two pretty nice pairs, but certainly some give and take between both of these pairs here today. I think some things I really like about both pairs and some things I maybe don't like as quite as much about both of these pairs, but I think a pair of pairs here that you really do have to appreciate for their type and kind. I think both cows are very, very similar in terms of type and kind here. Both really, really feminine, really deep body kind of cows. Cows that you have to appreciate their type and kind of. Both very, very sound kind of females. Gonna go ahead and use the cow with the February bull calf standing out in front of her here. Just a whale of a bull calf standing out in front of her. He's extremely stout, extremely round in his muscle shape. A calf that has a ton of top and a ton of dimension in him here as well. A calf that maybe just is a hair wide up through his front end, but I think a calf that has a bunch of power to go with it. A cow, I think, too, that you have to appreciate the amount of depth of body. She's a really, really soft-made kind of a female, really up-headed kind of a female. Female, you would maybe just like to change that udder a hair, but I think both females, you like to change the udder just a little bit on both of these. Let's move on to the second place pair. I think a pair that, again, you really have to appreciate the cow. She's extremely bold sprung. She's really wide when you get them behind her, hooks over to her pin. She's extremely stout and extremely square. Cow that's really, really nice in her type and kind. Maybe like to change that udder just a hair as well on her. A calf that maybe gives up a little bit in terms of performance. She's a January 1st calf standing out in front of this cow, and I think a calf that you really have to like the type and kind of maybe just gives up a little bit in terms of performance of this calf that's going to win this class here today, and that's probably why they're going to stand up at the top of this class. Just a nice pair of pairs here.
Thank you, Gar. So leading off in first place in our two-year-old Speckle Park class is entry 312, JSF Miss Whiskey, 27F, from Jonas Stock Farm, Maidstone, Saskatchewan, with JSF Redemption 41H inside. In second place, entry 469, Nada 110B Cat 202F, from the Goodfellows in Neilburg, Saskatchewan, with Nada 307E Cat 202H at side. Class 4 is next. These are our cows born 2017 or earlier with their calf at side. Class 4, again, two entries in this class.
Oh,
again, a pretty nice set of pairs and a pretty nice representation for the speckled breed here, I think. Going to use the three-year-old with an end-of-February bull calf to win this class here. Cal is just doing a whale of a job on this calf, a calf that just has a ton of mass and muscle, a bunch of hip in this calf, a calf that has a ton of crest in him as well. Lots of testicle under this calf as well, and just an extremely sound-made kind of a calf out here in front of this little three-year-old. The three-year-old's a really nice, pretty moderate frame kind of a cow, a ton of extension and length of body in this female, nice enough in her udder, and again, extremely sound kind of a female. Female is just doing a whale of a job and a very, very mature looking bull calf standing out in front of her here. So moving on to this other pair, I think you really have to appreciate the amount of mass and power and volume in this female. I think a cow that maybe isn't quite as nice up through her front end or coming out of her chest floor, but boy, you certainly have to appreciate the amount of power that this female has. She's extremely sound on the move for as much mass and muscle as that she has, and I think a female, when you get in behind her, you really have to appreciate how wide she is back through her hooks and pins and over her top. Again, maybe not quite as feminine as this cow is going to win this class, but I think a female that you certainly have to appreciate the amount of power that she has. As we look at the bull calf, a calf that maybe doesn't have quite as much crest, maybe not quite as much volume or muscle when you get in behind this calf, but certainly a calf that these exhibitors should be very proud of standing out in front of this cow here. Just a really nice set of pairs in this mature class.
Thank you, Gar. So leading off in first place in our mature cow class is entry 268, Prairie Hill Belinda, 52E, from Prairie Hill Ranch at Neilburg, Saskatchewan. Calf at side is Hell's Bells, 52H. Cool name. In second place, entry 470, Nada 13Z Jeanette, 203D from the Goodfellows at Neilburg, with calf at side, Crossfire 303H. We can stay in a ring. Stay in a ring. Stay in a ring. Don't leave us. And we're going to bring back the two-year-olds, and we're going to pick a senior champion from these four head that are coming back in. So senior champion female class will be in the ring now.
Thank you.
you've heard my comments on all these females, but I think a set of cows here that the breed should be extremely proud of, and I think with that I'll go ahead and select my two division champions.
So your senior champions from our age cow class, entry 268. Prairie Hill Belinda 52E with Hell's Bells 52H at side. And we're going to stay within the class for our reserve division, and she is entry 470, Nada 13Z Jeanette, 203D from the Goodfellows at Neilburg with Crossfire at side. We will see those cattle back in our championship female run, but let's head off into the heifer calves. And there are a slug of them, which is great. And we're going to start with class five, the junior heifer calves. Junior heifer calves coming in now. If you have your sale catalogs, there are three heifers from this class in the sale. All right? So class five, Speckle Park, junior heifer calves coming into the ring. Also, at this time, I'd like to recognize some more sponsors. Our premier and breeder and exhibitor for all breeds is sponsored by Borson Marketing. Our division banners by Weir Veterinary Services. The Supreme Show, which is lots of fun on Friday night, by Coca-Cola Bottling Canada. Also, Bow Valley Genetics will be offering collection credit to the top four females and four bulls of the Supreme. The Supreme Social is sponsored by Jason Arden and Associates, the Cooperators. The Angus Gold Show is sponsored by the Saskatchewan Angus Association. The Princess of the Prairies, Farm Credit Canada, and Sundown Livestock Transplants, Dr. Don Miller. Stockade Lady, Agland this year is a title sponsor. They got some really cool jackets for the Stockade Lady. I saw them back in the boardroom. The King of the Ring, the UFA, is a title sponsor. The Prospect Show is Northern Livestock Sales. The Junior Female Exhibitor Show is the Matrix Group, Ritchie Brothers, MG Angus, and Cran Stock Farm. Beyond the Barn is sponsored by Greenwood, the Payne Family Greenwood. The panels for the tout area supplied by Claussen Cattle Equipment, JCB Tractor and Bale Shredder from Tingley's Harvest Center, very much appreciated by the exhibitors as well. Chase the Ace, if you're here and you haven't got a ticket, I think there's a draw tonight, isn't that right? There's a draw tonight. Was it $23,000 if you draw the ace, isn't that right? Ace of Hearts? Ace of Spades or Hearts? I don't know. It's going to be good. You got to get tickets. They're $10 a peach. Ace of Hearts, yeah. Ace of Hearts, it's right there.
You're right.
First time I've been right all day. So, yeah, you can just go right over there at the administration office and buy tickets. You got a chance to win enough money for a really good night in Vegas. Okay. Class five, when you can travel. That's right. When you can travel, you just can't get home. Class 5, Junior Heifer Calves, Speckle Park Show, now in the ring.
Well, certainly a fancy set of heifer calves right from one end to the other in this class. Going to go ahead and use probably the most complete heifer calf in this class here. I think a heifer calf you really have to appreciate from the size. She's extremely soft made. I think a heifer calf that's really, really up-headed and really pretty up through her front end. Just a very, very feminine kind of a heifer, but a heifer that has a ton of muscle and a ton of mass and a ton of volume to go along with it. A really big top kind of a heifer calf. And a sound enough heifer calf when she gets out on the move here as well today. Just a really nice heifer to start this class. I think this heifer in second follows her probably the most closely of any other heifer calf in this class today. Maybe not quite as nice in her forerib of the heifer that's going to win this class, but boy, is she ever nice down through her middle third. Really, really strong top kind of a heifer, and a heifer that's really nice out on the move as well. Just a very, very soft made kind of a heifer, and again, a heifer that's really, really nice up through that front third of her body. Let's move on into this next heifer. I think a heifer, you have to appreciate the amount of top that this heifer calf has. She's really, really stout when you get in behind her. Tons of hip in this heifer calf, and yet she's really nice up through that front end as well. Heifer that maybe isn't quite as soft down through her flank or her middle third of these two heifers that are going to win this class. Maybe not quite as nice or as quite as up-headed as these two heifers are going to win this class, but an extremely stout kind of heifer to sit in this third hole. Move on into this next heifer. I think a heifer, you really have to appreciate the amount of mass. I think she's an extremely, extremely stout made kind of a heifer. Big hip, big top on this heifer calf, but she's a little bit bolder up through that shoulder, maybe not quite as nice in her forerib as the heifer calves that are going to stand above her here today, and that's the only reason she's going to sit in this fourth hole. Move on into this heifer at the other end of the class. I think a heifer that's extremely, very, very pretty kind of a heifer, just a little bit more refined of a heifer calf, maybe not quite as much of a mass or muscle in this heifer calf as the heifer calves up the other end of the class, but an extremely long body, an extremely fancy front, kind of a little heifer.
Thank you, Garth. All right, so leading off in first place in your junior Speckle Park Heifer Calf Champion is entry 309, Waldner Bliss, 052H from Notarance, and Jesse Waldner, Swift Current, Saskatchewan. In second place in your reserve junior Heifer Calf Champion for the Speckle Park Show is entry 265. Prairie Hill Hailstorm, 25H, from Prairie Hill Ranch, Neilburg, Saskatchewan. In third place, entry 903, Calico Creek Harris, 102H, from Calico Creek Speckle Parks, Yorkton, Saskatchewan, and she is in the sale later this afternoon. In fourth place, entry 904, Calico Creek Heirloom, 108H, again from Calico Creek Speckle Parks, Yorkton, she's in the sale as well. And in fifth place, entry 912, Wilcox Hillary, 121H, from Wilcox Livestock, again, another heifer that's in our sale at 5 p.m. All right, so top to bottom class, 5265 was second, 912 was fifth, 904 was fourth, 903 was third, and 309 was your junior heifer calf champion. All right, class six, now coming in the ring. Here's our February-born calendar year heifer calves. And mark your book, no fewer than five of these heifers are in the sale. All right? Class 6 will determine our intermediate and reserve intermediate Speckle Park Heifer Calf champion.
Yeah.
tonight.
Might sit down on my diamond, play tailgate, put in my country ride, hip-hop mixtape. Little Conway and little T-Pain might just make it rain. You can hang your t-shirt on a limb. Hit that bank and we can ease on in. Soak us up a little moonlight. You know I know what you like, yeah. All them other boys wanna wind you up and take you downtown. But you look like the kind that likes to take it way out. Out where the cornrows grow, roll, roll my boat. Floating down the Flint River. Catch yourself a little catfish dinner. Don't it sound like a winner when I lay you down and love you right? Yeah, that's my kind of night. Yeah, that's my kind of night. My kind of your kind is this kind of night. We dance in the dark and your lips land on mine. Oh, gonna get our love on. Oh, time to get our buzz on. All them other boys wanna wind you up and take you downtown. But you look like the kind that likes to take it way out. Out where the cornrows grow, roll, roll my boat. Floating down the Flint River, catch yourself a little catfish dinner. Don't it sound like a winner when I lay you down and love you right? Yeah, that's my kind of night. Yeah, that's my kind of night.
Really nice set of heifer calves right from one end to the other, and a lot of difference in type and kind in this whole class here right from one end to the other. I think there's a lot of variation here. I think I'm going to go ahead and use this really soggy made heifer calf to win this class here today. Just a very, very bold sprung kind of a heifer calf. Not the stoutest heifer calf in the class, but just an extremely broody kind of a heifer calf to win this class here today. Really, really bold sprung and really deep down through her middle third. I think a heifer calf that's really sound when she gets out on the move here as well today. Nice enough up through her front end. Just a very, very complete kind of a calf to win this class. Let's move on into this next calf. I think a calf that follows her quite nicely here as well. I think a heifer calf that's really deep down through her middle third. She's really soft in her makeup. A heifer calf that's really nice in her flank. Again, maybe not the prettiest heifer calf in the class, but I think a very, very broody kind of a heifer calf, and a heifer calf that's really sound out on the move here as well today. So moving on to this next heifer calf, an extremely fancy kind of a heifer calf. I think a heifer calf, you really have to appreciate the amount of eye appeal that she has, an extremely sound made kind of a heifer calf, and a heifer calf that's really, really angular up through her front end. Heifer calf that maybe isn't quite as soft as these two heifers that are going to win this class here today, but a stout enough heifer calf to stand in this third hole here. Let's move on into this next heifer calf. I think a heifer calf, again, that has a ton of eye appeal. A heifer calf that maybe is just a notch bigger frame than some of the heifer calves standing above her here today, but I think a heifer calf that you really have to appreciate the amount of style that she has. She's maybe just a tick straighter off of both ends compared to these heifer calves that are going to stand above her here, but just a really nice, very fancy kind of a heifer calf to stand in this fourth hole. Move on into this next heifer calf. Again, a very, very bold sprung kind of a heifer calf, but then a heifer calf that is maybe just a notch bolder coming out of her shoulder, maybe not quite as nice in her fore rib. She's maybe just a notch rounder in her hip shape, but I think a heifer calf that you really have to appreciate when you get standing in behind her. A heifer calf that has a ton of depth down through her lower quarter. I think a heifer calf that you really have to appreciate the amount of stoutness she has when you get in behind her. Just a really nice heifer calf. Let's move on into this next heifer calf. Heifer calf that maybe gives up a little bit in terms of muscles compared to some of these heifer calves standing above her, maybe just a notch bigger in her frame. But I think a heifer calf, you have to appreciate the amount of length of spine and the extension that she has up in her front end as compared to some of these heifer calves standing above her. Let's move on to these two heifer calves down at the other end. A pair of heifer calves that are really soft in their makeup. Heifer calves are really nice in their middle third. Heifer calves that maybe just get just a notch planer up in their front end as compared to some of these heifer calves at the other end of the class. But a very broody pair of heifer calves stand out at the other end of this class.
All right, Garth, thank you very much. So leading off in first place in Class 6 and your intermediate Speckle Park Heifer Calf champion is entry 909. Wilcox Cinder, 65H from Wilcox Livestock, Traherne, Manitoba. She is lot 13 in the sale this afternoon. Mark that down. Second place, reserve intermediate heifer calf champion is entry 459, Wolf Lake Halo, 93H from Wolf Lake Speckle Park, Bonneville, Alberta. In third, we had entry 460, Wolf Lake Harmony, 90H, again from Wolf Lake Speckle Park. In fourth, entry 263, River Hill 5C Heirloom, 555H from Carla Dutcher, River Hill Farm, and she is in the sale. In fifth, entry 269, Prairie Hill Hometown Girl, 406H from Prairie Hill Ranch in Neilburg, another sale heifer. In sixth place, at entry 458, Wolf Lake Harriet, 92H from Wolf Lake Speckle Park, again a sale heifer. In seventh, entry 660, Unlimited Spots Haven, 14H from Unlimited Spots at Marshall, Saskatchewan. And in eighth place, Wilcox Hopalong, 59H from Wilcox Livestock, Traherne, Manitoba, and she is also a sale heifer. Top to bottom, 660 was seventh, 269 was fifth, 459 was second, 458 was sixth, 909 was first, 460 was third, 911 was eighth, and 263 was fourth. So again, there were five sale lots from that class. Very good. Class 7's next. Senior heifer calves. This time there's five sale heifers because 659 won't be racing with us in the show. But there are five more sale heifers. Again, 659 is not in the show today. Class 7, senior heifer calves, January born in this calendar year. Thank you.
it's a heck of a set of heifer calves right from one end to the other in this class, and two really, really nice heifer calves to start this class out here. I think we're really splitting hairs between these two. One's maybe just cooperating a notch nicer here today, but I think going to go ahead and use this heifer calf to win the class. And I think a heifer calf, when she's standing there, she's extremely proud from it. She really wants to hold that head up. Got a very, very broody head under her, and I think a heifer calf that you really have to appreciate the length of spine. There's a ton of power in this heifer calf as well. She's an extremely, extremely long body kind of a heifer, and a heifer that's really, really sound when she gets out on the move here. Just a really nice heifer to win this class. Like I say, I'm really splitting hairs between these top two heifer calves here. I think the heifer calf that wins this class is maybe just cooperating a notch nicer here today. She maybe just wants to be here a little more, but I think this heifer calf that's standing in second hole is just a heck of a heifer as well. Extremely bold sprung kind of a heifer, really, really big top kind of a heifer, and a ton of power and muscle in this heifer calf. Lots of lower quarter in this heifer calf here today. I think a heifer calf you really have to appreciate up through her front end as well. Just a pair of really, really nice heifer calves, and I think a pair of heifer calves that could go either way here today. It'd be pretty interesting to turn both these heifer calves loose and just see which one you like better here. So we look at this next heifer calf in the third hole. I think a heifer calf you really have to appreciate down through her middle third. She's extremely nice in her lines. She's really nice in her flank, and she's really nice out on the move here as well today. She's really soft in her pasterns. Heifer calf that maybe isn't quite as eye-appealing up through her front end of these two that are going to win this class, but boy, she has a ton of brood cow potential in her as well. As you look at this next heifer calf, I think you have to, again, appreciate how nice this heifer calf is up through her front end. She's an extremely eye-appealing kind of a heifer. Very, very cowy looking kind of a heifer. She maybe just isn't quite as nice in her underline as these three heifers standing above her here today, just maybe notch higher up in her flank. But boy, is she ever sound when she gets out on the move here today. So you look at this next white heifer calf. I think a heifer calf, again, you have to appreciate up through her front end. She's extremely bold sprung. She's maybe just a notch bolder in her shoulder as compared to some of these heifers standing above her here today. Maybe gives up just a notch in terms of muscle when you get in behind her. But boy, she sure is a pretty kind of a heifer calf, and a heifer calf that you really have to like down through her middle third. An extremely soft made kind of a heifer calf, and a really, really nice heifer calf to stand in the middle of this class. As we move on to this next heifer, I think a heifer that just maybe is a notch bigger in her frame than some of these heifers standing above her here today. Boy, she sure has a lot of length of spine and a ton of extension as well here today. Let's move on to these next two heifer calves. Heifer calves maybe just get a notch plainer as compared to some of these heifer calves standing up above them here. But I think a pair of heifer calves, it'd be pretty exciting to put a little more time into and make into cows, because, boy, they have a ton of potential. Just an extremely, extremely strong top end of this class that could go either way.
Thank you, Garth. The good news, folks, the top two heifers are both in the sale. Look it up in the catalog. So 103 is your senior Speckle Park Heifer Calf Champion. She is KFC Hera, 16H from KFC Farms, Abbotsford, BC. And our reserve senior Heifer Calf Champion is entry 497, Greenwood Halo, 8H from Greenwood Speckle Park here at Lloydminster. In third, we had entry 262, River Hill Hidden Chance, 105H. Carla Dutcher, River Hill Farm at Lashburn. In fourth, entry 102, KFC Heroin, 12H from KFC Farms at Abbotsford, BC. In fifth, entry 43, Outback Oh My Bella, 8H from Wayne Meekin in Sturgeon County, also a sale heifer. In sixth place, entry 21, Colgan's Head Over Heels, 06H from Colgan Cattle Corporation, Saskatoon, another good sale heifer. In seventh, we had entry 672, Nada, 307E Cat, 202H. From the good fellows of Neilberg. In an eighth place, entry 658, Unlimited Spots Harlow, 01H. From Limited Spots at Marshall, another good sale heifer. So top to bottom, class 7, 672 was seventh, 262 was third, 21 was sixth, 659 was a scratch, 43 was fifth, 103 was first, 102 was fourth, 497 was second, and 658 was eighth. Again, our senior calf champion, 103, reserve 497, both are in the sale here at 5 p.m. All right, we are moving into our Grand Champion Speckle Park female class, sponsored by Movin' Spot Speckle Park and PAR Ranch. We will bring them in youngest to oldest. Our junior heifer calf champion is entry 309, Waldner Bliss, 052H. Reserve junior calf champion is entry 265, Prairie Hill Hailstorm, 25H. Our intermediate calf champion is entry 909, Wilcox Cinder, 65H. with reserve to 459 Wolf Lake Halo 93H. Our senior calf champion is entry 103 KFC Hera 16H. And reserve is entry 497 Greenwood Halo 8H. Happy birthday, Jax. He's accepting free Caesars all evening. All right. Junior champion Brett Heffer is entry 394 Girls Got Rhythm 110G from MX Ranch. Then our senior Brett Heffer is entry 100 KFC Girl Crush 699G. Reserve is going to be 42 is her entry number. Outback Chromed Up 102G. And we can put the pairs up on this side maybe, Garth, eh? So we can see them. Pairs can go right up here. So our senior champion females entry 268, Prairie Hill Belinda 52E. And a reserve senior champion females entry 470, Nada 13Z Jeanette 203D. Nice ring full of cattle. Our judge is going to get turned loose here, and he should have some fun here. All right. So our grand champion, Speckle Park female class, sponsored by Moving Spot Speckle Park and PAR Ranch, in the ring.
You know my
I think the Speckle Park breeders need to be pretty excited about the set of females standing out here in this class. I think if you could take all these females and put them in your herd, you'd have a heck of a herd or start out with this. But I think you've heard my comments already here today, but I think it's been a whale of a set of heifer calves right from one end to the other, and there's been a ton of good heifer calves we sent back to the barn here as well today. I think it's a pretty exciting set of heifer calves we have left out here. I think same goes for these two sets of bred heifers. I think it'd be pretty exciting to put these into production. I think there's a world of potential in these bred heifers here as well. So moving on to these pairs, I think a couple of pairs that have really proven themselves, a heck of a set of bull calves standing out in front of them here as well. I think with that, everybody should give these Speckle Park exhibitors a round of applause. It's pretty nice to see this crowd here, and it's a whale of a set of females.
Grand Champion Speckle Park female is the Girl Crush, KFC Girl Crush, entry 100, 699G from KFC, and your reserve champion is our senior heifer calf champion, 103 KFC Hera 16H, again from KFC Farms. They'll be receiving the vest from Moving Spot Speckle Park and PR Ranch. Pretty exciting, the reserve champion female is in the sale. All right, good deal. Thank you. We're going to have a quick picture break of the champion females before we get into the bull show, but we got a lot of bulls again in the Speckle Park show. Thanks again to Moving Spots and PR Ranch. And we're going to the backdrop with Christine back there to get some more pictures, and we'll be back shortly. Okay, we're pounding cupcakes back up here, but it's time to keep showing. Okay. Class 9, intermediate bull calves. So our top two will be our intermediate and reserve champion bull calf. Speckle Park show should be 5 head here, rock and roll. Again, thanks to our major sponsors, Matlock Farms, KR Livestock Supply, and Sweet Pro Feeds Canada. Speaking of which, the Speckle Park draw has been made, and KFC Farms wins the lick block from Sweet Pro Feeds. And Sundown Livestock did a special bonus draw for us. So $500 credit towards the donor flush in the year, and it was won by Prairie Hill Ranch. Prairie Hill Ranch, you won the flush from, or the credit to the flush from Sundown Livestock Transplants, my good old buddy, Dr. Don Miller. All right, here we go again. Class 9, Intermediate Bull Calf Speckle Park Show.
Yeah.
couple, again, some variation in type and kind in this class, but boy, I think we have two bull calves to start this class that are both pretty similar in type and kind, and a pair of bull calves I really like. Not extreme in any way, but I think a pair of bull calves that are complete in a lot of ways. So I'm going to go ahead and use this calf that has just a ton of presence here in the ring. He just looks like a little herd bull. I think a calf that, for a young calf, has a ton of crest already. Really nice down through his middle third. He's pretty nice coming both directions out of his shoulder, and really up-headed kind of a calf. Calf likes to get out here and move in this ring as well. Just a really nice calf to start this class. I think this next bull follows him in quite nicely as well. Maybe a calf, if you're going to fault him, he just isn't quite as nice. Both directions coming out of his shoulder, just a notch tighter in his forerib. But boy, does he ever have a ton of middle third in this calf. A calf that maybe isn't quite as strong in his top line, but boy, when you get him behind him, he sure is nice. Lots of muscle, really, really sound kind of a calf to sit in the second hole. Two really nice bulls to start this class. Let's move on to this next bull. I think a bull that you really have to appreciate the length of spine. He's an extremely long spine kind of a bull. Lots of testicle under this bull and lots of muscle. He maybe just doesn't hold his top together quite as much. Maybe not quite as soft mate as the two bulls that are going to win this class, but an extremely long spine. A really, really nice bull to sit in the third hole. Let's move on to this next bull. Maybe the most powerful bull in this class. I think a calf that has a ton of top, a ton of hip when you get him behind, and maybe not quite as much testicle. But I think just an extremely, extremely powerful kind of calf. He also gets a little bit bold coming out of his front end as well, maybe just a notch straight off that front end, but boy, you sure have to appreciate the amount of thickness that this calf has. Let's move on into this next bull. I think a bull you really have to appreciate how he gets out and moves when he wants to move here. I think a bull that you really have to appreciate the length of spine and the amount of depth down through his middle third. Calf that maybe isn't quite as bold sprung or quite as stout as some of the other calves in this class, but you sure have to appreciate the length in this calf. Just a really, really strong top end of this class.
Thank you, Garth. So leading off in first place in your intermediate Speckle Bart Bull Calf Champion is entry 313, JSF Dynasty 23H from Jonah Stock Farm, Maidstone, Saskatchewan. In second place in your reserve intermediate Speckle Bart Bull Calf Champion is entry 267, Prairie Hill High Caliber 5H from Prairie Hill Ranch, Neilburg, Saskatchewan. In third place, entry 270, Prairie Hill Hell's Bells 52H from Prairie Hill Ranch at Neilburg. In fourth, entry 314, JSF Redemption 41H from Joner Stock Farm in Maidstone. And in fifth place, entry 271, Prairie Hill Heavy Hitter 28H from Prairie Hill Ranch, Neilburg, Saskatchewan. Class 9, top to bottom, 270 was third, 314 was fourth, 267 was second, 271 was fifth, and 313 was your intermediate bull calf champion. All right, class 10 now, senior bull calves. Just three head in this class. Top two will be your senior and reserve senior Speckle Bart bull calf champion. Class 10.
Yeah.
a pretty exciting set of bull calves here in this class. Going to go ahead and use quite easily the strongest bull in this class here today. I don't know where you fault this calf. He's an extremely impressive kind of a calf right from the second he walks in. When he's standing still, he blows you away. I don't care what color you make this calf, he's good. Boy, it's pretty tough to find this much sogginess and this much hip and this much shape in a bull. And when you set this calf into motion, he's equally as good. Just an extremely impressive calf to start this class here. I think this next bull follows him quite nicely here. Really, really similar down through his middle third. He maybe just isn't quite as round, but tons of testicle under this calf as well. And an extremely impressive kind of a calf to sit in the second hole. I think a calf that would win a lot of classes at a lot of shows, but... Boy, he's a good calf as well. Just a really, really nice calf. He just gives up a little bit in terms of power, this calf that's going to win this class. Let's move on into this bull down at the other end of the class, an extremely long spine kind of a bull that maybe gives up a little bit in terms of masculinity and maturity as compared to these bulls at the other end of the class. But I think you really have to appreciate this bull calf on the move. He's extremely sound and extremely long spine kind of a bull. Just a whale of a bull to start this class here.
All right, thank you, Gar. So leading off in first place in your senior Speckle Park bull calf champion is entry 20, Greenwood Headliner, 71H, from Greenwood and Colgan's Cattle. All right, in second place, in reserve senior bull calf champion, entry 471, Nada Primetime, 312H, from the Goodfellas of Neilburg. And in third place, entry 673, Nada 307E, Crossfire, 303H, again from the Goodfellas at Neilburg. All right, so... we are moving now into the yearling bulls. Class 11, three head, top two will be your junior and reserve junior champion Speckle Park Bull. Class 11 coming in the ring. Remember, it's Chase the Ace draw night. Get your tickets right out at the main office right here. 20-some thousand if you pull the Ace of Hearts. That's big doings. So get over there and get a ticket as soon as you can.
Going
Well, again, there's a little bit of variation in terms of type and kind in this class, but I think there's three very impressive bulls in this class, and three bulls that the breed should be very proud of out here. I think I'm going to go ahead and use the bull that comes to the top of the class quite easily for me here today. I think this bull is pretty explosive in his muscle shape. He's really, really big coming out of his top and down into his rib cage. He's a very, very bold sprung kind of a bull, and yet he's still really nice up through that front end. He's really like the angle of that neck comes out of his shoulder, and love the head on this bull as well. Just a very, very proud fronted kind of a bull to win this class here today, and just a really, really nice, just a really complete kind of a bull to win this class here today. I think when you set this bull into motion, he's extremely sound, he's extremely square, and he really wants to reach off that front end. Just a really nice bull to win this class here today. Let's move on into this next bull. I think a bull that you really have to appreciate the muscle shape in him. You really have to like the hind leg in this bull and the amount of muscle that he has. I think you have to like this bull coming out of his top. He's a notch boulder up in his shoulder and his fore ribs, and this bull that's going to stand up ahead of him. And I think a bull that maybe doesn't have quite as much extension, maybe don't like the angle that his neck comes out of his shoulder quite as much. But boy, you sure have to appreciate the amount of muscle and the amount of shape and the amount of hips that this bull has. I think if we're going to pick on him a little bit, maybe like to change those front feet just a hair. But I think a bull that you really have to appreciate the muscle shape in. So we look at this next bull. I think the bull down at the other end of the class, an extremely long spine kind of a bull. Bull that does have a bunch of muscle shape. I think when you set this bull into motion, he does get a little bit outside his skeleton when he's wanting to paddle along, but I think a bull that does want to reach as well. Just a really long spine kind of a bull, and just a really complete kind of a bull. Just three nice bulls right from one end to the other, and extremely, extremely strong top end of this class.
Thank you, Garth. So leading off in first place in Class 11 and your junior champion, Speckle Park Bulls, entry 99, KFC Gladiator, 1G from KFC Farms, Abbotsford, BC. In second, and your reserve junior champion, Speckle Park Bull, is entry 19, Colgan's General, 20G from Colgan's Cal Corporation, Saskatoon, Saskatchewan. And in third entry, 472 MX Gambler, 169G from MX Ranch at Neilbert. All right. We're moving to the big boys now. Flip the page, Class 12, four big bulls coming. So these are 2018 born bulls, four head, Class 12, Speckle Park Bull Show.
I was gonna love you.
we certainly have four different types of bowls in this class here. I'm going to go ahead and use probably the most complete bowl in this class. I think a bowl that you probably like to peel a little bit of weight off of, but I think, again, a bowl that it's pretty tough to get hard on cattle that are easy fleshing, and probably the kind of bowl that you like to see a bunch of daughters out of because they'd be the same way. Just an extremely soft-sided kind of a bowl that's big enough in his top, a bowl that you really have to appreciate as he's standing still here, a bull that gets out and moves good enough here today in this class, just a really deep flank kind of a bull, and a bull that's packed full of meat and muscle here today. Like I say, a bull that's probably carrying a little extra condition, but a bull that certainly is that kind that that is an easy fleshing looking kind of a bull. So I think a bull that wins this class quite easily here. As we move on to this next bull, I think a bull you certainly have to appreciate when you set into motion, a bull that just floats around the ring here today, a bull that really likes to get out on move. I think a bull that maybe isn't quite as soft in his middle third or in his flank. You maybe don't like him as much coming out of his hooks and his pins as compared to this bull that's going to win this class, but certainly a bull that you really, really like when you set this bull into motion. As you move on into this next bull, boy, you sure like this bull up through his front end. Love the angle of that neck comes out of his shoulder. Love the head on this bull. Loved how erect front of this bull is. Big, big top kind of a bull. He's just maybe not quite as soft. These bulls are going to stand above him here today. Maybe just a notch harder doing look to him. But boy, is he ever stout when you get in behind him. A ton of hip in this bull. Lots of testicle in this bull. Certainly a bull that you have to appreciate for the length of spine. As we move on into this next bull, I think, again, you really have to appreciate the length in this bull. I think a bull that's really, really long fronted, really, really long spine, really long hipped. Bull that's just going to give up a little bit in terms of softness. Maybe not quite as deep down through his flank. Maybe doesn't want to move quite as much as some of these other bulls standing above him here today. But boy, you sure have to appreciate the length of this bull. Really, really strong set of bulls and a lot of different types and kinds in this class, but there's something for everybody here.
You bet. Thank you, Gar. So leading off in first place in our senior champion Speckle Park Bulls, entry 311. JSF Creed, 1F, from Joner Stock Farm, Maidstone, Saskatchewan. In second place, in reserve senior champion bull wave entry 461, Wolf Lake Field Ready, 52F, from Wolf Lake Speckle Park, Bonneville, Alberta. In third place, entry 18, Colgan's Fraser, CF11F, from Colgan's Cattle Company, Saskatoon, Saskatchewan. And in fourth place, entry 396, Wilcox Ferdinand, 1F, from MX Ranch at Neilburg. All right, our senior bulls from top to bottom, 461 was second, 311 was first, 18 was third, and 396 was fourth. We're going to move right into our Grand Champion Speckle Park Bull Show here now. Our vests are sponsored by River Hill Farms and Nada Ranch Speckle Parks. We're going to start with our Intermediate Calf Champion, entry 313, JSF Dynasty 23H. The Reserve Intermediate Calf was 267, Prairie Hill High Caliber 5H. Our Senior Calf Champion is entry 20, Greenwood Headliner 71H. The reserve senior bull calf was entry 471, not a primetime, 312H. Our junior champion bull was entry 99, KFC Gladiator 1G. Reserve is entry 19, Colgan's General 20G. And our senior bulls that just left the ring are entry 311, JSF Creed 1F, and 461, Wolf Lake Field Ready 52F. Our championship class Speckle Park Bulls is now complete, and what a nice set.
this has been a fun show to sort through today, and I hope it's been as much fun watching it, because boy, there's been something for everybody here in this show today. It's been quality right from one end to the other all day long here today, and I think the breeders should be really proud of the set of cattle that have been out here today. I think with that, you've already heard my reasons on all these cattle, but boy, the future's bright with a set of bull calves standing out here, and I think we've got four really, really nice bull calves standing out at this end of this class. So we went into our yearlings. I think a pair of yearling bulls of the breed should be really proud of, and a pair of bulls that I really like out here today as well. And as we move into these mature bulls, I think a pair of mature bulls that, just a really nice pair of mature bulls out here. I think there's, again, something for everybody in this class, and I think with that, there's two bulls out here that are definitely my type and kind, but go back to the barn and pick the ones you like back there, but I think I'm going to go and pick the two that I like the best here today.
Folks, let's give the exhibitors a big hand along with our judge, Garth Rancier. Nice set of cattle. Grand champion, Speckle Park Bull, is your senior bull calf champion. He is entry number 20, Greenwood Headliner, 71H. Golden's Calico are owners, and your reserve grand champion bull is your junior champion bull, entry 99, KFC Gladiator 1G from KFC Farms at Abbotsford, BC. Our vet sponsors again, River Hill Farms and Nada Ranch Speckle Parks. Now, before we lose our judge to pictures, we're going to quickly do our groups, please. Again, congratulations to everybody in the Speckle Park deal. What a great show. So, we're going to do some groups. And I know it takes a lot of people and some organization, but we need our breeders' herds. If they're not coming, please let us know. We have MX Ranch, KFC Farms, Colgan's Cattle Corps, and Prairie Hill. Steve Meyer, as usual, is right on top of it, so we have two entries left. 474 and 104 are scratched. Okay, all right. Oh, that makes things extremely easy. Thank you, Steve. Okay, so we just have two breeders' herds. 474 and 104 are scratches. Guys, breeders' herd. So we need Colgan's and Prairie Hill. As we move through the show the next few days, we're going to recognize some of our major sponsors. And right now we're going to acknowledge Matlock Farms Limited. As presented to me, I will read this off. At 106 years old, Matlock Farms is still going strong. A fourth generation family farm that celebrated its centennial back in 2014. What once started as a grain and commercial cattle operation has now migrated and shifted into a grain and purebred operation. Currently run by Jim and Greta Haydock with sons Cameron and Colin, the tradition of family farming is still going. In 1941, Byron Haydock purchased his first purebred shorthorn. That purebred became what is now a healthy herd of 60 purebred shorthorns that is still going strong. In addition to shorthorns, we also run about 40 purebred Angus cows. And recently, I picked up additional land that has allowed us to expand our grain operation to about 2,000 acres. Currently, we perform canola, barley, oats, and wheat. As a personal side hobby, the birthday girl from yesterday, Krita, also enjoys selling sweet pro tubs and has had great success in their herd for the last 2 years. Along with her sweet pro, she has also recently started using and selling Redmond natural sea salt minerals and clay products. Needless to say, Matlock Farms will be operational for a long while in its little spot on the hill 20 miles northeast of Lloydminster, Saskatchewan. Thank you, major sponsor, Matlock Farms Limited. All right, in the ring, Class 13, the breeder's herd. Sometimes these things can be an organizational nightmare. We've got her figured now. All right, so the Breeders' Herd, your first place will go to Prairie Hill Ranch, and second to Colgan's Cattle Company. No, so what we're going to do is if you have a pair of bulls, leave them, and we'll do that first. Or we can do Get a Sire. There's only one exhibit of Get a Sire. It's over here. Right, Tammy? You got to Get a Sire? And that's it? Our first place Get a Sire is on the west side of the ring from Colgan's Cattle Company in Saskatoon. Cattle Corporation, pardon me. Tony's always wanted a corporation, now he's got it. Excellent. Congratulations to Colgan's. And the new bull, that's pretty exciting. Giddy up. All right. Now, pair of bulls. Again, 274 is scratches, 475 is scratches as well. So there should be three, Prairie Hill, Joner, and Colgan. This is the most punctual group deal we've ever had in a Speckle Park show. I'm going to tell you that right now. Very impressed right now. Very happy. Oh, I see. I say that, and then Nikki sent one away. We got big problems now. Okay, Garth is all over that. He's way ahead of me. So first place in the pair of bulls will go to Colgan's Cattle Company, second to Joner Stock Farm, and third to Prairie Hill Ranch. Congratulations, everybody. What a great Speckle Park show. Remember, folks, if you're interested in these good cattle, you need to be here at 5 o'clock and go back in the stalls and look at these sale cattle. The T-Bar crew's put together a great set of sale cattle. Okay, so yeah, I will announce this. So Matlock Farms is donating a pallet of 8 Sweet Pro 20 tubs to be auctioned off, with 100% of the proceeds going to Lloyd X Foundation. Sweet Pro Feeds has decided to match Matlock's donation of 8 Sweet Pro 20 tubs to be auctioned off, with 100% of the proceeds going to the Lloyd X Foundation as well. So that sounds like 16 tubs. Yeah. Right, Mike?
Yeah.
Giddy up. So the Lloyd X Foundation exists to enhance our agricultural and urban communities by providing facilities and resources for development and conducting of business through education, cultural, social, and recreation activities throughout the year and for future generations. It's a great deal and a great cause to support. So one of these pallets of 8 tubs is going to be auctioned off during the sale here at 5 o'clock, the Speckle Park, the homecoming sale. I imagine to start off or end the sale, I'm not sure which. Start of the sale. Okay, and then another one will be auctioned off during the King of the Ring Championship Drive tomorrow evening. Correct. And each pallet, the value is about $1,400. So a great donation from Matlock's and Sweet Pro Feeds. Thank you very much. And with that, we're going to reconvene at 3:30 for the Shorthorn Show. Remember, sales at 5, get back into Barnes and have a look at that great set of cattle on offer, and we'll see you in a little bit.
Thank you for everyone joining us for the Speckled Park Show on DLMS today. We are going to be stopping this broadcast and starting a Shorthorn Show at 3:30 p.m. So, and the sale for the Speckled Park is at 5 o'clock. That was a great time to sign up to bid, and we'll get you approved and ready for that sale going at 5 o'clock here at the Stockade Roundup.